Hello everyone, I Sayed Nawaz. I welcome back here to my YouTube channel Petroleum Universe. So as you can see on the screen that even in today's video we are going to discuss about properties of crude oil. So in my previous video I have been discussing all these properties, and in today's video I am just going to discuss that how this formula, let me use a pointer over here, that what is the formula for formation volume factor, and is there any constant, then how that constant has been derived, and we will see one of the numerical approach related to formation volume factor. Okay, so as you know, the formula for formation volume factor is over here. I am just discussing about the gas. So the gas formation volume factor is represented by BG, which represent you the volume of gas at different places, which is nothing but the volume at reservoir condition and volume at surface condition. Okay, so if you further simplify this equation, we know that the formula for real gas equation is nothing but PV equal to ZnRC and nRT. Okay, then over here, if you see that we have two condition of gas over here. The first one is real gas, which is under reservoir condition. So for that particular equation, we are going to use this this equation for substituting the value of V. And for ideal gas, which will be at surface, which means that here we won't be having any kind of compressibility. Okay, so for that we are using the formula, same formula, excluding compressibility, which is nothing but Z. Okay, so as you simplify this equation, then this turns to this particular equation, which is nothing but V equal to ZnRT by P. So I have just substituted the formula VG equals to ZnRT by P. This is nothing but real gas equation at reservoir condition. Then over here you just neglect this Z. Okay, because the compressibility at surface is very negligible when compared to the compressibility at reservoir condition. Okay, so this volume at surface condition is represented as nRT by P. Okay, then after that, if you just see that over here, that this R and this R will get gas constant will get cancelled, and apart from that the number of moles at surface condition and at reservoir condition will be same. So that will get cancelled over here, and at surface condition we won't be having any kind of compressibility. So that BG will get changed into, at reservoir condition we will get ZT by P, and at surface condition we will get as only T and P. Okay, so I hope you understood up to here. So let us jump for next slide. As you can see that the number of moles does not change for both reservoir and surface condition, and if you see the compressibility at surface, it will be negligible, as I said in the previous slide, when compared with the compressibility at reservoir condition. Okay, and these are two standard surface condition that we use globally, that the pressure what we have used, the one atmospheric pressure will be equal to 14.7 psi, and we will be using 60 degree Fahrenheit globally as the surface temperature when we are dealing with the formation volume factor. Okay, so let us see. Right, so I am just substituting the surface value over here. But over here I just wrote 520, which is nothing but the temperature at surface condition, and in the calculation of BG we are using in terms of Rankines, degree Rankines. Okay, so for that purpose, as you can see the units over here, that temperature is in degree Rankines, and this BG is nothing but the units of this BG is feet cube per SCF, standard cubic feet. Okay, and reservoir pressure is obviously PSI, what I didn't wrote over here. So the surface condition, as one more point I need to tell you, that to change from degree Fahrenheit to degree Rankine, we have to use the conversion factor as 460. Okay, so including this 460 plus this 60, the surface temperature which turns to 520, and 14.7 psi is the temperature as a surface pressure what we have used as a standard. So once we simplify this, we will get the value as ZT by P, and the simplification of this particular term is nothing but 35.3741. Okay, so if you further simplify this equation, then you will get an equation for BG, for calculating BG, which is nothing but 0.02827 into ZT by P at reservoir condition. Okay, so I hope you got this derivation, how we got 0.02827. okay, but you have to remember one thing, that you have to use this particular equation when the units of formation volume factor, gas formation volume factor, is in feet cube per SCF. Okay, then and moreover that, in some equations we will get units in terms of barrels instead of feet cube. So to calculate in terms of barrels, we have to use this formula, as we know that one barrel, if we want to convert one barrel into feet cube, then we have to use 5.615 as a conversion factor. And what I mean to say is, one barrel is equals to 5.615 feet cube. Okay, so to convert this feet cube, this formula, from feet cube to barrels, we have to use 5.615. I am just dividing by 8. So finally I got the answer for BG in terms of barrels is nothing but 0.005035 into ZT by P, where you have to understand that this BG will give you the condition of reservoir. Okay, although we have some different factor which will give you the condition at surface, that how gas will expand at the surface, that we'll say as gas expansion factor. Okay, so this formula we have to use when our units for BG is nothing but barrels per SCF. Okay, so let us jump for a numerical approach. So this is a question what we have. A gas well is producing at a rate of 15,000 feet cube per day from a gas reservoir at an average pressure of 2000 psi and a temperature of 120 degree Fahrenheit. And we have to calculate the gas formation volume factor when our Z compressibility is 0.78. Okay, so let us see the formula what we have to use. As you can see over here, that so I am just calculating in terms of feet cube per SCF. You can even calculate in terms of barrels per SCF. So over here I am using 0.0287 ZT by P, this formula I am using over here. And apart from that, I have just substituted the value 0.78 as compressibility, and over here the temperature is given in terms of Fahrenheit. I have to convert that in terms of Rankine, so I'm just adding 460 as a conversion factor. Then the average reservoir pressure is 2000 psi. Okay, so if you further simplify this, then you will get an answer as 0.00639 feet cube per SCF as formation volume factor. So this formation volume factor, if you want to calculate at surface condition, then that you will consider as gas expansion factor. So expansion factor is nothing but, as I said you previously, that if you consider, it will be a reciprocal of formation volume factor. So which is what I did over here, it is 1 by formation gas formation volume factor, what I get the value as 0.00639. so that value I got as 156.49 SCF per feet cube. Okay, so here if you see that once you get an gas expansion factor as 156.49, then it tells you that the gas, this particular feet cube of gas has converted into this particular SCF per feet cube of gas when it comes from a reservoir to surface. Okay, so I hope you understood everything in today's video. If you have any kind of doubts, then you can use my mail address, which is nothing but nawaz.delta.au@gmail.com. And apart from that, if you like this video, then hit like, share, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon to receive a latest notification of my videos. So that's an end. Thank you so much. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.